Hello again, and welcome to this thought for the day for Monday, the 25th of May. We hope you find something of interest in these talks, and we always enjoy getting your comments on them. Today, I want to think a little about in-between times. In-between times. We all have these experiences. It might be something as banal as waiting to board a plane after you've checked in. It might be waiting for examination results at school, college, or university. It might be waiting for a loved one to emerge from surgery. From the trivial to the potentially life-changing, these all have in common a paralyzing sense of helplessness. Much may hang on what will happen. Even planes get delayed at the last moment and travel connections are lost. But there is nothing that we can do to affect the outcome. It is out of our hands. We are in an in-between time. The church year is marked by two such times with which we're all familiar, Advent and Lent. In both seasons, we look forward to a major festivity which approaches inexorably as the days go by. If we really observe Lent, we shall do something positive by way of preparation during this in-between time. For many, Advent is typically taken up with more secular preparations involving Christmas card posting, present buying, and food shopping. Ascension Tide is a third in-between time in the church calendar and is a bit of a Cinderella in the family. What is the significance of the 10 days between the Ascension Day and Whit Sunday? Are we even aware of it as such an in-between time? How was it for our Lord's disciples? Did they see themselves as being in an in-between time? The answer, I think, would seem to be yes, but in a rather different way. Let's think about what those disciples had experienced, what they had been told, and what they were expecting. They had followed Jesus for 3 years, rejoiced in his jubilant reception by the Jerusalem crowds, despaired and fled at his crucifixion, exulted in perplexity at his resurrection, and gloried in his ascension. That is what they had experienced. They had been told that following the ascension, they should return to Jerusalem and wait for some kind of new presence of God at whose nature they could barely guess. That is what they had been told. What were they now expecting and when? They weren't sure what, and they did not know when. They returned to Jerusalem after the ascension, rejoicing and praising God. In doing so, they were going back into an unfamiliar big city environment. They lived their lives in provincial Galilee, and Luke tells us that they went into lockdown for fear of those around them. They might have been excused for opting to head back to healthy Galilee, but they dutifully followed the injunction to remain in hostile Jerusalem. They had no idea how long they might have to remain in that locked down state. You might consider that their situation shows some parallels with our own hunkering down in fear and waiting for some sort of emancipation, but not knowing how long we might have to wait. Pentecost, Whit Sunday, is next weekend, and we don't want to get ahead of ourselves, but there may be some value in looking at how those disciples conducted themselves in that in-between time with no certain end date. By turns, confused, hopeful, fearful, and expectant, they nevertheless kept the faith against all the odds, during an open-ended time of anxiety with no clear outcome. We could do worse than to take time this week to put ourselves into those disciples' sandals and to reflect on how we are measuring up in our own frustrating in-between time. P.S. For what it's worth, and without getting above ourselves, I don't think we're doing so badly.